Rev Fam, Toby Tejano here, and you're tuned in to Rev Plus, your ultimate guide to choosing your next ride and so much more. Are you feeling the summer heat? Well, maybe it's because we're just a few weeks away before we say hello to summer. And with all that in mind, this is also the perfect time to hit the road and go on an adventure. For this episode, we've gathered three of the best from our most recent season to show you the perfect road trip kind of ride. The Honda CR-V is a versatile and reliable compact SUV that's designed to take on the open road, making it a perfect companion for your next road trip. This is what the front grille looks like for the all-new CR-V. In terms of ground clearance, you have 198 millimeters of ground clearance to go with your daytime running lights and your sequential turn signals. Now, there's a new feature for your lights, and that's the auto-leveling feature that does give you more safety and convenience, especially when you're out on the dark roads. Now, to go with that is your piano black honeycomb grille to match a sportier vibe, especially for the RS hybrid variant. Now, to go with the overall look of the car, to be able to distinguish this compared to the other variants a new CR-V offers is the blue accents on the logo. Having the blue accents on your logo does signify that you're driving a hybrid. Let me show you what else the CR-V has to offer. You also have a cargo capacity of 581 liters with the seats folded up. And as you can see, there is plenty of space inside. I fit properly, see? And I'm 6 feet tall. Not that I would be sitting in the back here, but at least you have a little bit of reference. Now, going with that as well, here in the back, there's a bit of an indent here in the floor, and that may be the provision for the battery. But another thing to also consider is that in case of emergency, you have a tire inflator kit here in the back. Now, let me show you what the CR-V looks like from the inside. Now hop in the back of the Honda CR-V, and this is the kind of space you are dealing with. First of all, getting in and getting out, it's more than efficient and it's more than effective. It's pretty fine, the doors open pretty wide so you don't have a problem, and you'll also like the idea that there's more than enough leg room here in the back. I'm 6 feet tall and this is my sitting position, and that's my preferred driving position at the front. And as you can see, there's enough knee room, but you gotta remember that these seats are also reclinable to give me more space for more comfort. Now going with the space and comfort for the car, you'll also like the idea that the windows are pretty big so you can see everything beside you, but also you have a panoramic glass roof here up on top to give you more space so you don't feel claustrophobic if you do get stuck on traffic. Now, if you do get stuck on traffic though, you'll also like the idea that there's plenty of comfort features available for you if you're sitting in the back. You'll like the idea that there's two air vents here in the back to give you all that cooling that you want on those hot Manila days, and two USB Type-C ports down below to give you more provisions should you be low bat in any of your gadgets. Speaking of gadgets, if you're a fan of music, you'll also like the idea that throughout the entire CR-V, you have Bose speakers all throughout so you could be able to enjoy your music wherever you go. Also note that there's also speakers on the doors so that you could be able to get the best sound quality possible. Now, if you're sitting in the middle, you'll also like the idea that there's a bit of a flat floor down here on your foot room so that you have just enough space should you be in the middle. Now, should there only be two passengers here in the back also know that there's a foldable armrest down here to give you more space and comfort. Now, if you're traveling with kids, know that there are ISOFIX tethers available. And for the RS variant, also know that the red stitching continues all the way here to the back. With the Honda CR-V, you can already tell with the new hybrid technology this car carries, Honda's already unlocked an entirely new dimension. You got a lot of cleaner energy while you're driving this car out here on the open roads. Now, on the way to today's location, I was actually averaging roughly around 23 kilometers per liter. But surprisingly, while I've had this car out here on the open roads, that number got a lot better, meaning I actually got as high as 42 kilometers per liter out here on the open roads. Now, you might be wondering, how was that possible? And it was made possible because of the hybrid technology going well with the ICE technology that this car carries. Now, you still have to gas this car up, but because of the regen and because of the battery that this car has, you don't have to gas this car up as much compared to your traditional ICE engine. You have three drive modes for this car. You have Eco, you have Sport, and you have Normal mode. Now, there's a bit of a delayed throttle response when you're in Eco mode, and that's mostly because the car is trying to get the best fuel economy possible. But when you want to move, just move a few switches up and you're on sport mode. And that's what sport mode sounds like. And once it gets back up to its highest speed, or once you get back up to your desired speed, the car does go back to its EV mode, so you could get the best fuel economy possible. And really, that's the nice part with the Atkinson cycle. You can really see how old mixes in with new to give you the best results possible. Now, it does beg the question, what do you do with range anxiety? What happens if you, quote-unquote, run out of battery? Well, don't worry, though. If you run out of battery, well, the car does go back to its ICE configuration automatically. Remember, it goes hand in hand, so it does help each other out one way or the other. But if you notice your range going lower or getting close to zero, don't worry. All you gotta do is go to a gas station and fuel up. After the break, let's talk about a fully electric SUV that you can enjoy either as a passenger or as a driver. Keep it here on Rev Plus.